I see many men wearing suit and tie, but instead of preaching truth, all I hear most of them preach is lie. I wish I did not have to talk about this, but then if I keep quiet, many more youth will die. Was it just for you and I that Christ God himself had to choose to die? Some call it redemptive suicide. I fix my gaze around and all I see are self-righteous Pharisees, Sadducees, praying God protect me, bless me, and it's all me, me, and me. So I keep wondering, so how about the unbelievers across the street that we all see? I have Christ and I'm saved, hallelujah, but he's right here in my pocket. You have Christ and you're on your way to heaven, praise the Lord. Oh, I said praise the Lord, but you're keeping your Christ in your closet. He is for us and ours alone, but please do not forget a man in his sins passed on a few hours ago, and heaven is a place he will never call home. Lord, use me. Lord, use me. Oh, Lord, please use me. And it's all now a cliche. Meanwhile, the Spirit keeps prompting you to speak to that brother or sister every day. But I guess we are too busy going about our businesses or looking for the next miracle center to get our heads to go and lay. We seem to be more interested in looking up for fault in our brothers. So we wait upon another who would sin. So we put him on a guillotine and slay. Then we come to church all dignified and diplomatic, ready to bind and to claim. When we have left off the original mandate of going ye into the world to preach to every breathing clay. We are too careful to mingle with the prostitutes, the weed smoker, the drunkard, and the gay. So once a while we pay them a visit to check whether or not they are okay. And in 5 minutes we share the message of salvation, after which we declare them saved, but we care less about how the fruits remain. I know many will hate me for these that I say, but today's people need more than just 5 minutes. They need your relationship, so please stop pushing them away by showing them boundaries and limits. Enough of the gimmicks. I'm tired of living and believing in fallacies. Be not unequally yoked with unbelievers, misinterpreted. So sinners have not become our enemies.
I don't want to be seen with the bad boys, cause as a believer, those are allergies, eh?
So it's all about us and our families. Please check the message to the Church of Sardis, and I pray you understand me. The Lord keeps reminding us, but how often haven't we ignored? We glory in coming to church and using our gifts, but all in the church ignorant of the fact that out there is a waging war. If we do not wake up to this truth and call, we will be losing this fight and much more. It is time for us to move out of the cement and blocks and reach out to the thugs with the dreads and locks, for they too are wonderful children of our God. Inviting them to church is good, but not enough. For you are the church, and out of you must spring true love. Let's begin to live like the Christ we profess by paying attention to the dying world out there, for our God does not love them less. For if our God so loved the world in John 3:16, then we who are born of the Spirit and of the blood and we carry life ought to be doing same. The life Jesus lived on earth is our blueprint, the solid rock upon which ye ought to build your church, God's very own temple. Every step he took, every piece of work serves for you a perfect model. He ate and dined with sinners. They were his family, so he called them brothers. Today we are thankful to God for the lives of the apostles, but who were they before Christ came? Worldly men with sinful struggles, but Jesus loved them and lived with them all the same. He cared less about the critics and what the theologians would say. He was all about his Father's business, to seek and to save. Today there are a lot of Peters, Lukes, Matthews, and Johns out there waiting to be made disciples, disciples in Jesus' name. So the question is, for how long will ye keep chasing after drink and meat when ye have been called to walk in and operate in those beautiful feet? For how long will you be a fisherman when you have been called to be a fisher of men? If you believe you are a saint listening to me as you make merry and engage your cutlery, please do not forget this is the reason why our Savior had to hang on the cross of Calvary, just so all who believe might have life and have it more abundantly. For this is the call, this is the essence of Easter, the reason why our Savior had to go through the torture just so he can reconcile lost men back unto the ever merciful Father.